Saw the last match.
Yeah, you just leave those blocks alone.
Yeah,
you're not supposed to touch my blocks.
I am counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 blocks.
So for this episode, we're gonna throw some history in the mix, something we haven't done in any other episode. But in order to do that, we must first go to a very mythical place, one that I've only heard stories about. Let's go.
We're all going to the library. We'll have so much fun.
And this, my friends, is the treasure. Mountaineering in the Gore Range, a record of explorations, climbs, routes, and names by Joseph D. Kramarczyk, published in 1989. If we open this up, spiral bound, to the preface, there's a little part I want to read to you guys. In 1979, I climbed a peak in this range and subsequently encountered a decided lack of information about the Gores. My mountaineering interest led to a decade-long quest to cover these mountains on foot and to uncover as many of the records of explorations and ascents in obscure reports and long-forgotten publications that I could find. Joe, I have no idea who or where you are, but serious round of applause to you because this thing is incredible. People watching this, if you're interested in the Gores, I highly recommend going to your public library and seeing if they can get you a copy to borrow. So like he says, this book mainly focuses on mountaineering routes in the warmer months whenever there's no snow, and I'm more in the ski mountaineering camp. But the real reason I grabbed it is for the history of some of these mountains. Now let's open this thing up and see if we can't find some history about our point of interest for this episode, Deming Mountain. Paraphrasing a little bit here, Kramarczyk states that in maps from both 1929 and 1970, there was no name for this high point. However, a survey marker on the summit denotes it as Deming Mountain, which refers back to the Deming family from 1888. A little bit about the Deming family. It all started when John Deming followed his father Elijah Deming to Colorado, where John established roots in Frisco, and he and his wife had 7 kids, and they basically spent all their time fishing, hunting, and exploring in their backyard, which was the Gore Range. Pause for a bunch of noise over there. After many generations of Demings being in the community, locals began to refer to the rounded peak as Deming Mountain, and it stuck. A little bit of research beyond the book that I found, an article posted in 2008 by the Summit Daily said that the Deming family is still in Colorado, and they celebrate their family's history every year by going to the top of Deming Mountain. Pretty awesome. So Deming is one of those mountains that Kramarczyk states it's unsure who was the first to climb it or when that happened, but it's a total possibility that it could have been somebody from the Deming family. At least that's what I like to think. So after all this research about Deming Mountain and the family that it's named after, I'm curious if any of the family members have ever skied it. And in particular, the couloir that drops off the north side called the Deming Drop. Let's learn a little bit more about that.
Because Deming Mountain is in the southern end of the range, we'll be starting and ending our day in Frisco at the Meadow Creek Trailhead. And by we, it'll be Adam, Luke, Wes, Ryan, Patrick, and myself. We'll follow the creek for about 4.5 miles until we reach Deming's southeast face, which we'll use to climb to the summit. Just on the other side is the north-facing, zigzagging, 1,300-foot couloir. After riding the line, we'll have to climb just under 1,000 more feet to regain the saddle and eventually link back up with our original tracks. Overall, the day will be about 11.5 miles with about 4,500 feet of vertical gain.
That's a gamble.
I got 6.
that's all there is.
6916.
Hello, good morning. We're about 4 miles in, got about 2,000 vert. We have our first eyes on the southeast face of Deming, which we're gonna climb up. Coolers on the other side. Got a group of six today. It's a lot, but we got the Holy Cross boys plus Adam and Luke, so it's a good crew. Pretty freaking cold out. The winds were just pumping out of the north yesterday, so really hoping that it's not just completely stripped with snow. It is a pretty protected line, so we're hoping that the wind didn't fully get to it, but definitely there are three flanks in the line that have a northeast aspect that we're definitely gonna have to treat with caution and just evaluate for any wind slab, one of those being at the very summit. So don't know till you go. And this is one of those lines where you really can't get any beta on it unless you go up there, because it faces into the heart of the Gore.
Going to the candy store. I take six of these and six of those and six of them and six of the others. And also six of the red, six of the white, and six of the blue. I put them in one bag. That's 42.
Check out Wes, he's laughing at me.
We love vlog, bro.
Really cold. Really windy. So we're gonna keep summoning video to a minimum here. I'll see you in the line.
Won't die in a downtown, not for nine. Then there were six hungry men. They had $9 each.
Yeah!
And they went downtown, and the waiter said, sit down. Oh, it makes a big difference how you spread it around.
6 times 9 is 54. 9 times 6.
See that prince over there?
Let me play a sad song for you on the world's smallest violin.
This is serious.
I know. This really is the world's smallest violin. See?
Nice and close. It's edible, it's good.
We'll be right back.
I saw the brim turn, I just thought NASCAR and
nice one.
I was coming in so fast. This is a great kill spot right now.
I'm so down for chilling. It's everyone's favorite part of the tour. Regain the ridge, get out of here.
That's a wrap. Deming Mountain, Deming Drop. We have a long slog out of here. You know how it goes. See you back at the cars.
You know, I hate to break this to you, Bert, but six isn't anybody's favorite number.
It's my favorite number, Ernie.
I mean, six just sort of sits there between five and seven. You know, you have five fingers on your hand, and there are 7 days in a week, but there's not really six of anything.
Oh, thank you, dude.
Cheers, buddy.